sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words and what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, it is written that Abraham had two sons, one by the slave woman and the other by a freeborn woman. The son of the slave woman was born naturally, the son of the freeborn through a promise. Now this is an allegory. These women represent two covenants. One was from Mount Sinai, bearing children for slavery. This is Hagar. But the Jerusalem above is freeborn, and she is our mother. For it is written, rejoice, you barren one who bore no children. Break forth and shout, you who are not in labor. For more numerous are the children of the deserted one than of her who has a husband. Therefore, brothers and sisters, we are children not of the slave woman, but of the freeborn woman. For freedom, Christ set us free. So stand firm and do not submit again to the yoke of slavery. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever.
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever.
Praise you, servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever.
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever.
From the rising to the setting of the sun is the name of the Lord to be praised. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens is his glory.
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever.
Who is like the Lord our God, who looks upon the heavens and the earth below? He raises up the lowly from the dust. From the dunghill he lifts up the poor.
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever. Alleluia.
They were doing things tremendously against the
Jonah, not our father, that is, the prophet, to the Ninevites. And as you know, Jonah did not want to go. You know why? Because you know how tough those people, the Ninevites, were, and so did Jonah. He thought, Lord, you're asking me to do this, but I don't want to go there. That's a tough neighborhood, and they're probably going to eat me alive. And then Jonah also had a problem as well, because he didn't want to preach and they'd be converted, and they would see the mercy of God. Sometimes you and I don't want the blessings of others because we think they should be condemned. Do you know what I mean? So a group of people or persons that are not really following the good way, have not really responded to God's love. We don't want to convert them, change them. We want them to get what they deserve. People today use that word karma. As Catholics, we are to avoid that word, as you know. I know some of our friends use that word who profess Catholicism. But Catholics should never use the word karma. You know, let them get what they deserve. And that's what Jonah's whole thought process was. But nonetheless, God wanted Jonah to be a sign for the Ninevites. And you know about he was swallowed up in the belly of the whale for 3 days and 3 nights. Almost like that, of course, mirrored image of Christ being sent to a people that were tough and hard to really crack. They were a people who were obstinate. But nevertheless, God our Father sent Christ to make sure that they be converted and they have the mercy and the love of God. Jesus spent 3 nights and 3 days in the belly of the earth. My brothers and sisters, the sign, of course, is the sign of Christ, who desires mercy, who desires conversion for all souls, and who does it out of love for their eternal salvation. The world is seeking a sign today, and it's looking for many people and places. The sign is that of Christ. You and I, in a particular way, must re-evangelize a whole nation. A nation that was already evangelized to. Your parents and your grandparents received the message of the gospel. And how faithful they were to that message. And they taught you the powerful sign of Christ's victory over sin is salvation, a whole way of conversion, a metanoia, a changing. This generation is an evil generation, Jesus says in this Gospel of Luke. But you and I know that the gospel is timeless. So Jesus is saying among us now, this generation, it's an evil generation, and it seeks a sign. But no sign will be given it but the sign of Christ's victory over sin and death. So everything that we could possibly do to promote the good of God and to help people have a conversion of heart by our prayer. Look at Saturday, we had that beautiful rosary rally, didn't we, at Upper Stafford Park? About 50 people came. That was a wonderful example of re-evangelizing, to making sure, yes, today there are people who pray the rosary. Yes, there are people who believe in Jesus Christ. Yes, there are people who know that the sign of salvation and redemption is that of Christ, and not afraid to promote it, to speak to our children. I say this because you and I already know that many, many people do not attend Mass now. Really? Under 25%. So, the popular religion now is non-practicing Catholics. That's the religion that really has the most numbers. It hurts us, and it's sad. Today, as I try to engage in people and friends and relatives and high school people that I grew up with, it's so sad now that out of 1 to 10, how many people get married through the sacrament? 1. Mostly 9% of the 10, 90% of them get married in a park or on a beach. They don't believe in the sacrament of marriage. Re-evangelization again. Just like those missionaries came to this world to evangelize us. This generation is an evil generation, and it seeks a sign. But no sign will be given it except the sign of Christ through you and through me. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For the church, may the Holy Spirit continue to lead us to a deeper conversion and faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civic leaders, may the Lord guide their work of serving the needs of their communities. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are oppressed, may God deliver them to safety and freedom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, may the grace of this sacrament bring us closer to Christ and one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have gone before us in faith, may they find eternal rest and joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Beverly and Joseph Zapata, Barbie Augustine, Brendan Avento, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Helen and Louis Carley, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal means of St. Mary's Parish, the temporal mission of St. Mary's Parish, and its spiritual mission given to us by Christ as a sign to the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray to gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
bread we offer you, through the fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Through Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. And Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who have thou saved and glorified by numerous miracles, the Blessed Virgin Mary, immaculate from the first moment of her conception, grant that all who bow to thee implore her protection on earth may eternally enjoy your presence in heaven,
who with the Father and the Holy Spirit live and reign God forever and ever. Amen.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who for the accomplishment of your greatest works, have chosen the weak things of the world, that your flesh may glory in your sight, and who for a better and more widely diffused belief in the immaculate conception of your mother, have wished that the miraculous medal be manifested to St. Catherine of Mary. Grant, we beseech you, that filled with light and humility, we may glorify this mystery by word and work. Amen. The Memorare. Remember, our most compassionate Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your assistance, or sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, we fly to you, O Virgin of Virgins, our Mother. To you we come, before you we kneel, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not our petitions, but in your clemency hear and answer them. Amen.
The Novena Prayer.
O Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of our Lord Jesus and our Mother, penetrated with the most lively confidence in your all-powerful and never-failing intercession, manifested so often in the miraculous medal, we, your loving and trustful children, implore you to obtain for us the graces and favors we ask during this novena, if they be beneficial to our mortal souls and the souls for whom we pray.
We pray, of course, for our parish of St. Mary. And we pray for all those people, for whatever reason, are not attending Sunday Mass, or even minimally watching it virtually. We ask that God, through the intercession of our Blessed Mother, bring them home. We also pray for those who are sick in body, mind, or spirit, especially those names listed in our Sunday bulletin, and all those people who have asked us to personally pray for them. May Jesus, the divine physician, bring them healing and strength. We also pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for his intentions for the Church, the missions, and his personal intentions. We also pray for those who serve our country in any capacity, especially those names listed in our Sunday bulletin. We pray for our first responder and our essential workers. We pray for all those who protect and defend us. And in a special way, we pray for all those who are ill through this pandemic. May our Blessed Lady, Star of the Sea, continue to help them and strengthen them, especially through these essential workers and our first responders. We also pray for our parish here at St. Mary. We pray for our school, prep, RCIA, Adult Information, and we pray for all those organizations and ministries that are part of our parish. May God, who brings all things to completion in one, in Him, continue to draw ourselves to Himself and from Himself to evangelize to the world. We also pray for your special intentions that you have bring to this Novena today and every Monday. May God, through the intercession of our Blessed Lady, hear and answer your prayers. You know, O Mary,
how often our souls have been the sanctuaries of your Son, who hates iniquity. Obtain for us then a deep hatred of sin, and that purity of heart which will attach us to God alone, so that our every thought, word, and deed may tend to its greater glory. Obtain for us also a spirit of prayer and self-denial, that we may recover by penance what we have lost by sin, and at length attain to that blessed abode, where you are the Queen of angels and of men. Amen.
An act of consecration to Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal.
O Virgin Mother of God, Mary Immaculate, we dedicate and consecrate ourselves to you under the title of Our Lady of the Miraculous
May this medal be for each one of us, a sure sign of your affection for us, and a constant reminder of our duties towards you. Ever well wearing it, may we be blessed by your loving protection and preserved in the grace of your Son. O most powerful Virgin, Mother of our Savior, keep us close to you every moment of our lives. Obtain for us, your children, the grace of a happy death, so that in union with you, we may enjoy the bliss of heaven forever. Amen.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Now let God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice day, everybody. St. Michael,
the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God rebuke him, we humbly pray.
And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan,